Hey guys! Today we're going to answer some of the frequent questions that you've left us on our videos about the live steam hobby. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Over the last few years, many of you have had questions about the live steam hobby. So we thought we'd take some time and answer your most frequent questions directly. So let's get started. This is the most common question we receive on our live steam videos, and there are two answers. Many folks involved in this hobby build their own equipment from blueprints. This is the cheapest route, as the modeler only pays for the raw materials required for the build. However, this route requires welding, machining, and other fabrication skills, and the tooling to perform the work, which can be costly. Modelers electing this route can purchase blueprints from several vendors. We recommend checking out Little Engines. They have a line of 11 steam locomotives and offer blueprints and castings to help your project get off the ground. Another route many hobbyists select is purchasing ready-to-run equipment. There are several vendors who supply ready-to-run locomotives, freight cars, trucks, and couplers to hobbyists that would like to get on the rails fast. L&B Trains offers custom building services to hobbyists and can fabricate a wide range of custom locomotives, freight cars, and passenger cars. Titan Trains also offers an impressive line of no-weld freight and passenger car kits, which are available for purchase as ready-to-run models or as easy kits for folks who would like to do some of the work. They also offer various diesel locomotives which come ready to run. For trucks and couplers, you can visit Live Steamer Parts or Titan Trains. Both vendors offer lines of Bettendorf freight car trucks, modern freight car trucks, and couplers to finish off your project. Titan Trains also offers four-wheel and six-wheel passenger car trucks. This is another common question we receive, and the answer varies based on what you're looking to model and how you plan to build it. Steam locomotives are some of the priciest items in the hobby because the amount of custom machining that is involved in their construction. Those who wish to do the machining work themselves can cut costs substantially. However, they must have access to a metal lathe and a milling machine. A set of castings for a smaller locomotive, say a 10-wheeler, will cost you around $4,500. A casting set for a larger locomotive, say a 484 Northern, would likely run you in the range of $10,000 from Little Engines. These casting sets, however, only complete the locomotive's chassis. The modeler then must build or purchase a boiler for the locomotive. Using the same two examples, a boiler would cost $3,000 for the 10-wheeler and approximately $7,500 for the Northern. Ready-to-run diesel locomotives can be commissioned much cheaper. Smaller switchers, such as the SW1500, can be ordered for a base price of $8,500. Larger locomotives, such as the -9, GP30, GP9, and SD40-2, can be ordered from Titan Trains for a base price of $14,300. L&B Trains also does custom locomotive construction, and interested parties should contact them for more details and a quote. For freight cars, hobbyists should expect to spend roughly $400 to $900 for kits and $700 to $1,600 for ready-to-run cars. Most vendors charge extra fees for painting, graphics, trucks, and couplers. This should be considered when ordering cars. Freight car trucks typically cost $300 to $400 a pair, and a set of automatic couplers will range between $50 and $75. Ready-to-run four-wheel passenger car trucks sell for $1,400 a pair, and a six-wheel passenger car truck will set you back $1,700 a pair. Most hobbyists belong to a live steam club, such as the Illinois Live Steamers or the Prairie State Railroad Club, or have private built tracks on their personal property. Membership dues vary by club. The ILS charges $276 per year and an additional $50 a year to store your railroad equipment at the club. Each club has a different policy on pulling the public. Some clubs that are situated on public land are required to have a certain number of public run days per year. Other clubs, like the Illinois Live Steamers, are private and do not permit in the general public. There are various reasons for this closed-door policy. First and foremost is the issue of liability insurance. This insurance must be purchased when the clubs allow in the public to protect themselves should someone get injured on the property, and it is very expensive. Our colleague Blake is a strong advocate of coal. It is an authentic fuel for these machines, and firing with coal keeps the engineer busy while in operation. A drawback of this fuel is that it is extremely dirty, and it will cake your locomotive with ash and soot. If this ash is able to work its way into your bushings or bearings, it will score them up. Your administrator here on the Steam Channel prefers locomotives fired with propane because gas is much cleaner than coal, and the continuous burn of gas allows for constant even fire throughout the firebox. Burning gas will also help keep your locomotive and you looking sharp and clean. Propane is also much easier to find, and with an efficient burner configuration, it is cheaper than coal over the long term. Coal is also becoming harder to find and purchase thanks to all the new regulations coming out of the EPA. Well, I hope this video helped answer some of your questions. If you can think of anything else, feel free to leave them in the comment section below. Stay tuned for our upcoming videos, one of which will be a how-to video on how to build a Titan train caboose. Hey guys, thanks for watching this video here on the Steam Channel. If you enjoy our videos, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and like us on Facebook for daily steam photos and videos. Why not keep the water boiling? Catch another iron horse in 1080p HD by clicking on the video preview to your right.